The Philippines has an ambitious plan to fully revolutionize its reliance on energy sources. It is reported and planned by the government that the nation is aiming to have a 56% reliance on renewable energy sources by 2040. A bold and ambitious plan, because these renewable energy sources have just contributed only 20.8% as of 2019. How will the nation of the Philippines achieve such a plan? Well, that is through solar, an abundant energy source across the world. Within the Philippines, it is amongst the best renewable sources of energy, with around 3.6 pesos per kilowatt hour, far lower than the wind, which is around 6 pesos, and hydro, around 5.4 pesos. This is even lower than coal-fired power generation, which sits at around 3.8 pesos. With such potential, this will likely one day mark its way as the Philippines' single largest producer of energy. But that is if the nation does put enough resources and capital to fully maximize the potential. What we have seen so far, however, is quite profound. Private corporations are quite amazingly the movers of this initiative. Billionaire Enrique Rezon, with his company Prime Infrastructure, had planned out the world's largest solar power facility, one that will have a capacity of about 2,500 to 3,500 megawatts, along with a 4,000 to 4,500 megawatt battery energy storage system. Further, Solar Philippines, the nation's and Southeast Asia's largest solar company, is even seeking to build 10 gigawatts of panels, and Ayala Corporation subsidiary Akin Renewables is an aspirant to not only build the local communities, but become an international producer of energy. While the numbers indicated may sound insignificant, it is in fact a lot. 1 gigawatt of solar projects can approximately employ over 20,000 people and theoretically can power around 750,000 homes to 1 million homes. The solar power potential is obviously incalculable at this point, as power from the sun is said to be very abundant. But clearly, within the Philippines, the private corporations are taking charge very quickly. It may show that there is a lot of room for them to profit as solar power costs continue to drive down, and the next frontier of the energy revolution is within sight. Anyway, what do you think about that?